In this episode, some flashing light sequences or patterns may affect viewers who experience photosensitive reactions.
Hi, bookstores! Today, we're going to be scientists! Whoa, I love science! I wonder what would happen if I pour some of this. With this. Wow! That was. But remember, friends, do not mix things together on your own. Always get an adult to help. I wonder if there's a way for me to do science that's not so messy. I mean, just for those times when I like my clothes to stay their original color. Jen, the librarian.
Hi, friends. You know, I love when we do science experiments during programs at the library. One of the best things about science is that it's happening everywhere, in so many different places and in so many different ways. STEM learning doesn't just have to be about an explosion.
Right.
Even though those are fun. Yeah. And it doesn't have to only happen in a lab.
That makes sense. Wait, I thought we were talking about science, not STEM.
Well, science is part of STEM. Okay. See, STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. And sometimes when we say science, we mean all these things together.
Right, when we play or ask questions, explore the world around us, or solve problems, we are building our brains through STEM.
Absolutely.
Yes, science is happening everywhere, and it's happening all the time.
Hey, let's go find it!
Ooh, good idea!
Let's do it! Ah!
Go
there is science everywhere.
Science wherever you are. You can also supercharge your learning and fun by doing planned experiments, like the ones we saw Sheneatha doing earlier. Hey, that reminds me. My librarian friend Kat is setting up some activities for a science program we're having at the library later. Maybe Sheneatha and I should check it out. Hi, Kat.
Hi.
We were wondering if you could show us some of the cool experiments you're setting up.
Of course, come take a look. Here, we're observing what happens when we drop different objects into water.
Ooh.
Try it.
Oh my goodness. Bookstars, do you think this rock will sink or float? Let's see.
It sinks! Whoa!
Yeah, but not all things do.
Let's try this apple.
Ooh. Do you think this apple will sink or float?
How does it feel?
Let's find out.
Whoa!
Some of my book friends and I thought that that would sink.
Yeah.
The secret is inside the apple. Mm. Apples have lots of air pockets, and air is less dense than water. So the apple floats.
Interesting.
Nice. I wonder what else floats.
Wondering, experimenting, and sharing discoveries are all part of doing science.
Awesome. Now, my friends did the same experiment at home, and they recorded it.
Ooh.
You want to see it?
Yeah.
Let's check it out.
Check it out.
This is our pool, and this is all of our stuff. And then these are our little categories. It'll sink or float.
I think this is gonna sink because it's pretty heavy and pretty light. I don't think it's gonna sink, but I think so. Oh, it floats!
Do you think that will sink or float? What's happening to it?
Float. Yes. Put it in the float category. I can't reach.
Your turn, Jack.
Oh, that floated!
That floated. Now, what did you think was going to happen?
I think it was going to sink because it was so heavy.
But it didn't. Why do you think it floated? What's it made out of?
It's made out of wood.
Oh, you want to try that one? What do you think, Jack?
Sink.
What do you think, Cleo?
Sink.
Let's try it. What's it doing?
Floating.
It's floating. Why do you think it's floating?
Can we a pizza?
Yeah, we'll have pizza now. Okay, say bye everybody.
Bye. See you later.
That was so cool. You can ask your grown-up to send in a video or a photo of you or your family doing everyday science anywhere. You may be on the next episode of Book World. Just email it to bookworld@bklynlibrary.org. You can get more details at the website.
Once children have discovered what sinks and what floats, they're ready for a special challenge.
Ooh.
Making this ball of clay float.
Whoa!
Do you mean that you can make something that sinks float?
Wow.
I wonder how. Let's see, maybe if I change the shape.
You know, now you're talking about shapes like squares and circles, so you're bringing math into it. Awesome.
Yes, that is awesome.
Maybe like a, like curve?
Oh, curve like a boat kind of?
Like a boat.
Check out what I've got going on over here.
Wow, these flowers are so I just want to touch them
and smell them
and draw them.
Exactly. Those are all awesome ways of exploring these flowers. You can also look at them up close with a magnifying glass. Take them apart to see what's inside. And you can put all the flowers together, all the stems together, and all the leaves together.
Whoa, who knew there was so much to explore about flowers?
And you're doing it with the help of technology. You're using your magnifying glass to take a closer look at the parts of the flower. Technology includes using tools like this to help us solve our problems.
Whoa, we don't usually think of technology like that. You know, it's not just computers or phones.
I love it!
Do you hear that music?
I do.
Let's go check it out.
Ooh, what's going on? We're about to get this pasta moving and grooving thanks to the bubbly chemical reaction of baking soda and vinegar.
Ooh.
I've got some water here. First, we need to add the baking soda. Now, it's really important that all of this baking soda dissolves.
Ooh.
And the best way to do it is to count to 10. Let's count together.
All right. Ready?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten! Awesome job!
Oh, good job, book stars.
All right, now we're ready for our dancers. I'm going to pour these pasta pieces into the pot. All
right. Sheneatha, look, it sinks.
And now let's make this a real dance party.
All right.
Pour the vinegar into the cup.
Ooh.
Whoa! Keep going! Keep going!
Whoa!
I almost
got this.
Whoa!
Should we do green, blue, orange, pink,
pink?
Or, yes, yes,
pink.
Yes, pink it is.
One, two, three, and go.
Yes!
I love science.
You know, all we need now is a stage to dance on.
Maybe I can use some blocks to make one.
And that's engineering.
When you design or build something, you're thinking like an engineer.
Now,
let's dance!
Oh!
And grown-ups, you can visit our Book World page on the library's website for details on how to do these experiments, ideas for questions to ask to further learning, STEM events at the library, and more.
Oh, and of course, a list of books.
books!
Absolutely. Actually, pairing a book with an experiment on the same topic is a great way for young scientists to learn more and make connections with their world.
And grown-ups, don't forget to send in your videos and photos.
Let's dance.
Remember, STEM doesn't have to be hard. Whether you're walking down the street or doing a planned experiment, opportunities for science are everywhere!
Everybody!
Well, Bookstar, that's my cue. See you next time!
Made possible by generous funding through City's First Readers, an initiative of the New York City Council.